Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. For those of you that don't know me, my name is Kylie. I am a licensed medical esthetician and also the owner of Skin Facial Spa in Largo, Florida. So for today's video, I'm going to be doing part 3 of our skincare Q&A. I know I've been doing a lot of facial videos recently, but I definitely want to get back into more of these talking type of videos and more informational videos. I kind of just wanted to do a little facial series just to kind of show you guys the different treatments that I have. My original plan was just to do one of each type of facial, but I got a lot of interest from so many people about wanting to be filmed. So there's a couple of kind of each treatment on my page. But yeah, I asked you guys on Instagram to send me in your skincare questions. So all the questions in today's video are going to be coming from you guys. There's not that many, just a few, so that hopefully this video won't be super long, but we all know that I could probably talk forever about each question. All right, so the first question is, how often should I wash my face? Every day or every other day? Girl, let me find out. You've been washing your face every other day. So you need to wash your face every single day. Nighttime is most important, especially if you wear makeup. You need to be double cleansing. It's not necessary that you wash your face in the morning, as long as you're sleeping with clean pillowcases and you've done a really good job at cleansing your skin the night before. But you definitely need to wash your face every single night. It is very, 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 very important. The next question is, how can I use an extraction tool at home, prep, how to do it, and also what products to use afterwards? So I actually never recommend that people use any extraction tools at home. If I told you that, I would not be doing my job. Okay, I don't like people extracting at home because if you're not a professional, it's just not a good idea. You're most likely gonna create some really bad scarring, if not permanent scarring, that's gonna take a lot of time and money to work on. Also, you can spread further bacteria, which is just gonna lead to more acne, so please just don't do extractions at home. I know that's probably not the answer that you were looking to hear, but as a professional, I just can't answer this question. Really honestly, and suggest that that's ever a good idea. The next question is, what causes acne? So there's a lot of different causes of acne, and a lot of people always think that it's a hygienic problem. It's not. Or makeup. It's not. Okay, so there's so many different causes of acne. The most common thing is going to be your genetics. Mostly people with oily skin get acne. That's not always the case, but that is a pretty common thing that happens. Products that you use, if you're using the wrong products for your skin and they're actually breaking you out. Hormonal fluctuations is definitely the most common cause of acne that I see. Foods you're eating, alcohol can flare up acne. Just so many different things. Not taking care of your skin, not getting professional treatments, or using products that are right for your skin that are really clogging your pores. Not washing your face properly, which, like I said, it's not a hygienic thing. Like, it's very rare for it to be a hygienic thing. That's why people get acne. Like, I hate the stigma that people think, like, if you have acne, you're like dirty or you don't wash your face, because 9 out of 10 times that isn't the case. There's so many different causes of acne, so you would definitely have to meet with a professional to kind of rule out what could be causing it and how to treat it. The next question is, what can I do for my maskne? So it's actually a really good question right now. I know it's something that almost all of us are dealing with, and I'm not wearing any makeup in this video, so I'm sure you can see I'm breaking out a little bit on my chin. They're mostly healing, and I've kind of found ways to make them, you know, calm down a little bit, so I will share those with you. Number one thing is to wash your face before and after the mask. Number two is to, depending on what kind of mask you're wearing, if you're wearing like a cloth material mask, you need to wash it every single day, which I know is kind of like, you know, kind of annoying to do. And if you're wearing a disposable one, throw them out after each use and get a new one. You also want to keep your skin really hydrated under the mask, so make sure that you have a good moisturizer on. And serum, hydrating toner before the moisturizer. You can also use a spot treatment or a salicylic acid face wash after the mask. It's gonna help kill the acne-causing bacteria in the skin and kind of slow down the oil production in the sebaceous glands. So you can use a salicylic acid facial wash, or you can use a benzoyl peroxide or a salicylic acid spot treatment and just treat the little pimples every night and sleep in that. Another thing that you can do is you can put on a thin layer of CeraVe healing ointment or Vaseline, some kind of petroleum product, and kind of apply a thin layer of that where the mask touches your face, because it's going to prevent any irritation. It's also going to keep your skin really hydrated. The main thing about maskne is that every time you talk, you're creating humidity under that mask and it's getting trapped in there. Another thing is the friction, because it is so close to your mouth. So if you're talking or doing anything, basically it's like rubbing against your skin. So that's the cause of it. Hopefully you can try some of those treatments out and they'll work for you. They've been really working for me. So I know it's a very annoying thing to deal with, but it is something, unfortunately, that we're probably gonna have to be dealing with for a while. How do I stop breaking out after I work out besides washing my face? So she said she's already washing her face after she works out, which would definitely be my number one suggestion. Besides that, again, a spot treatment with salicylic acid or benzoyl peroxide might help a little bit. It's just about doing your skincare routine, you know, after you work out. Also wash your face beforehand as well, but you don't want to overstrip your skin. All right, should I wear SPF even though I'm wearing my mask? So she's talking about the lower half of her face and she's wearing a mask. Does she need to wear SPF? So yes, you do. If you think about it, the sun, the UVA and UVB rays can penetrate even with 80% cloud coverage in the sky. So if you're not even being protected on a very cloudy, rainy day, you're definitely not being protected from the sun just because you're wearing, you know, a thin piece of cloth over your face. So yes, you definitely do, especially since you don't want to have any uneven skin tone or any discoloration. So if you're putting SPF on the top part of your face and not the bottom, you might have a little uneven skin tone problem. So just wear it all over your face. There's no reason why you shouldn't. And also, if you're using an SPF moisturizer, it's going to help keep your skin hydrated under that mask so that it doesn't get dried out and irritated. So it's going to help with masking you as well. All right, the last question. I said this is going to be a really short video. I didn't have that many questions for part three, but I did want to make a part three anyways, just to answer the questions that you guys did have. So last question is, how can I avoid wrinkles? So the number one thing you're going to want to do is to wear sunscreen. Wear your SPF every single day, SPF 50. You can also use antioxidants, vitamin C, retinol. Those are all things that are going to help avoid premature aging. Alright you guys, so that concludes part three of the skincare Q&A. Sweet and short. Hopefully I answered some of your guys' questions for you. Of course, if you have any more, feel free to DM me on Instagram. I'm on there kind of a lot. Whenever I'm not working, I'm on there, and you guys can always feel free to message me and ask me any questions that you have. I will see you guys in my next video. Thank you guys so much for watching.